Okay, so I'm José from Traity. Thank you everyone for being here. And for those of you who don't know me, you might have a question in mind, which is, who are you and why should I trust you? And that's a good question, I think. Ah, I have to be here for the micro. Okay. So who are you and why should I trust you? I think that's a fair question to make because nowadays there are many people that you don't know and you don't really know what to expect. They might be crazy people out there. Yeah, in this big world, you never know who's going to be at the other side. And to answer that question, there are two parts. One is who you are, and the other one is why should you should trust me. So regarding who you are, that's identity, because identity is who you are. Whenever I think of identity and who are people, I always think of some basic personal data, like the typical things that are in the ID. In my case, I'm Spanish. So this is the Spanish ID. And it shows some basic information of me. Well, not of me. This is a generic ID card. And it tells about my nationality. So for instance, it says that I have a particular name and I come from Spain. And the reason we trust this thing is because first, it's issued by the Spanish government, which is the only one who can say who's Spanish and who's not. And it's very difficult to fake. It's very difficult to force. So it's unlikely that another person issues this and appears to be the Spanish government. And also, I am the only one who can use this ID because the picture is there. In case you had doubts about the picture, you could still go to the police and check out the fingerprints if to really know if that ID is representing me or a different person. So basically, it provides some value, something, it says something about me, and the involved actors are very difficult to impersonate. So both the Spanish government and both myself can be trusted. So this is something that can be trusted, and it's something that we are comfortable with when using cards. I might have a bunch of cards in my wallet, and I can show the ones that I want whenever I want. And that's something that we are happy with in this in the offline world. And the thing is, how can we translate all this experience that we like and that we are in control of our identity to the online world? There are many ways that we can emulate cards in the online world. By using asymmetric cryptography, we have these public and private key pairs to identify ourselves. So I might be identified by a public key, and by using my private key, which is a kind of password for me, I can authenticate myself and I can sign certain messages to say certain statements about other people. So the way it would work when emulating these cards, it would be something like this. Like I could be holding a reputation card that says that I have 5 stars reputation. I am the holder. I am this ID 3V4RN49, whatever. I can prove that I'm that ID because I'm the owner of the private key associated to that. So I can authenticate as that ID. And this card has been signed by that ID, A1, CD2, CD, whatever. And that's the issuer. So imagine that Traity is the individual who is issuing this card. So Traity is saying that I have 5-star reputation. And similarly, you could think about kind of trust cards. So someone is trusting me. Again, I am the holder. This person signed this card and gave that to me. And I can carry this card and show people that someone is trusting me. So the way this would work in real life would be that I authenticate as this ID, 3B4N whatever, and then I can show these cards, like I have 5 stars reputation or that someone is trusting me. But the problem here is, well, I told you that the first one is Traity, the second one is, let's say, a friend of mine who says that he or she trusts me, but who's A1, CD2, whatever, I told you it's Traity, and who's this other ID? So first I proved my identity by using some authentication using my public and private key pairs, but now you're wondering about who are those people who are saying things about me. So in this case, you are wondering about my reputation, because my reputation is what others think of me. That's the reason why you should trust me. First, I address the first part of identity, and now it's all about what other people think of me. So when dealing with this situation where you don't know about the identity of other people who are making statements about me, there are two possible approaches. One is what we could call axiomatic trust. In this case, what it means is that we don't know those IDs, those public keys that were saying statements about me. And one approach is, okay, you have a kind of whitelist. So the first ID, I tell you that it is Traity, and that it's a trusted organization, and you can hardcore that in your system and say, okay, whenever this ID releases or issues a five-star reputation card, I would trust that. So then everyone with five-star reputation that was issued by that ID would be trusted. And similarly, you could have that Alice, the one who trusted me and issued that trust card, could be trustworthy if you already know that thing. So it would be about having these sets of public IDs and storing that in your system, and consider that everything that comes trusted from them is trusted as well. So that would be like adding some axioms to our system. The other approach would be a completely decentralized trust. So in this case, you are not trusting anyone by default. So you don't really know who those IDs are, and you don't trust any ID by default. And in this case, the only approach possible is trusting, analyzing the trust network, analyzing the interactions, analyzing all the data that those IDs could have associated, and also the age of the account. So it's not the same an account that was created 1 week ago or 1 day ago, which could be a spam account, compared to an account that is, like, let's say, 5 years ago with some interactions between people, that is also trusted by more individuals. So it's all about analyzing the trust network and the interactions that this network has. So there are many challenges here. I already mentioned how this the asymmetric cryptography could help in achieving this kind of solution. But first, one of the issues is where's the data? Do we really own the data? So in the current situation, mostly Facebook or Google own the data. Most people have a lot of data there. In this case, you are not really in control of the data. You depend on what these organizations are doing with it. It's not owned by you. There are some other alternatives, like having that in your devices, using some of the other frameworks like Open MasterSheet, MadeSafe, or StoreJ. Possibly they are not still widely adopted or mature. It's in some cases it's a work in progress, but obviously it gives more freedom to the user in the way of how they can own the data and manipulate it. Also regarding privacy, there are privacy concerns here. So for example, when I came to France, I had to show my ID and show my nationality. And this is a kind of reputation system where they trust people coming into a country just because they notice that, okay, you have a European nationality, then you are allowed to come to this country. It's that kind of reputation system. But the thing with that is that I release some information about me. Perfect. I release some information about me. Is this okay? Okay, so it's something that happens. And there are two possibilities here, which is whenever I'm not using a verifier, like a Traity could be, I have to share all this data all the time so that people can trust me. If I was using a verifier like Traity, then I have to trust Traity, this verifier, but at least I only have to share that data once. That's a different approach. And another possibility is that I could be faking the whole network of people who are trusting me, of people who are making statements about my reputation. Of course, that's a problem. I could create a whole network around me. It's not so easy if interactions are inside something like blockchain, so some independent ledger, in a way that I cannot go to the past and modify those interactions. So that ensures that if you have interactions of around 5 years with people from one network, they are real and they are happening. So coming back to the first question, and I'm finishing already, which was why you should trust me. What you had in mind actually was what this is OuiShare Labs. I think it's really difficult that I faked the identity of OuiShare Labs, and brought Joachim and Auli here, and this looked like OuiShare Labs, actually. So you are kind of trusting user identity, and as only OuiShare can let someone speak at OuiShare Labs, you are kind of trusting my reputation as well. So let's say that you applied some kind of axiomatic trust and decided to attend to this talk. So thanks for that, anyway. Thanks for listening.